A polar bear on dry land. The image is as beautiful as it is alarming. From its home in the Arctic Circle, this animal has long been a symbol of the harmful effects of climate change, and it's in danger of disappearing. Geoff York has studied the bears for more than 20 years. Today, the American scientist is in Canada's Hudson Bay, hoping to catch a glimpse of the elusive creatures.
Polar bears can be very difficult to spot. They lie down, they can find little cracks in the rocks, they can be in the bushes and completely disappear from us.
In winter, polar bears are excellent hunters. They can ambush seals on the ice with little effort. But in summer, as the ice melts, seals find refuge in the ocean and swim too fast for their white predators. Deprived of prey, this 600-kilo male won't be eating anything for several months.
This bear's waiting for the ice to freeze. It'll be on shore now until probably mid to late November before it's able to get back out and really hunt. So while these bears sit on shore, they're losing a kilo or two every day that they're here. That can go for about 180 days before they really start to have a problem.
Studies conducted by Geoff York and other experts are categorical. Each year, the ice is melting earlier and refreezing later, putting the survival of the world's remaining 25,000 polar bears in danger.
Polar bears are spending up to a month longer on shore than their parents or grandparents did. Bears are more likely to wander around, look for something to eat, and if they're in poor body condition, they're going to be more risk tolerant, and that might bring them into interaction with people.
The residents of the small town of Churchill in Canada's Manitoba province have a special relationship with the bears. Here, the proximity to the animals makes locals proud, but it is also a source of concern, especially when they start to venture closer and closer to inhabited areas. For this reason, Geoff York's NGO has set up a sophisticated surveillance system.
This is a Spotter RF radar system and a point-tilt-zoom camera that goes along with it. It's a very nice new toy.
The scientist and his team hope the device will help protect the 800 local residents.
This is to detect polar bears coming into a community or a camp. Ideally identify them as polar bears. This can work 24/7. It can see in the dark when people can't. It can see in snow, rain, fog.
The radar follows the movement of the animals and can let residents know if one wanders within 2 kilometers of the town. And it's not their only protective measure. This is Officer Ian Van Ness. His mission is to divert the attention of bears and drive them away from the city.
We may have to haze the bear. A lot of times it might just be the horn on your vehicle. So a simple horn like that. Or we might have to get out on foot and grab our shotguns and cracker shells and head out onto the rocks and pursue that bear and shoot those cracker shells, obviously to the side of the bear. You do not want to hit a bear with a cracker shell. That would not be good.
Ian patrols the coastline near the village, where bears often make an appearance.
Typically, you know, we come here in the morning, we do a patrol first thing in the morning before school starts to ensure that the kids are going to be safe walking to school. This is polar bear country and they are very dangerous.
In summer, after the ice melts, another Arctic species makes an appearance in the vast Hudson Bay. Like a never-ending ballet, beluga whales show off their pearly white skin shimmering in the water. Their frequent, piercing vocalizations have earned them the nickname of Canaries of the Sea. From a boat, Argentinian researcher Valeria Vergara watches over the beluga whales. The belugas are pushed into this estuary when the sea ice melts. The bay offers them protection from predators and also provides them with a plentiful food supply.
When ice conditions shift and there's less undersurface of the ice for that phytoplankton that in turn will feed the zooplankton that in turn will feed, you know, big fish, there's a shift in prey availability for beluga whales in some areas of the Arctic.
For belugas, ice acts as a shield against the noise of human activity, which can interfere with their way of communicating. Their vocalizations, which come in whistles, clicks, squeals, and chirps, are essential to their survival.
There are areas that are entirely losing ice, and so with that enters more noise, really. A lot more vessel traffic, cargo ships, passenger traffic. When you study how a very sound-centered species communicates and lives in an underwater world where they really need to rely on sound for pretty much every aspect of their lives, you begin to understand why underwater noise pollution is such an important issue.
Back in Churchill, the mayor is counting on the bears and whales to attract more tourists.
The opportunities are there for local people to have an opportunity for economic growth. It's time, I think, that the North is developed. But keeping in mind, yes, there's some of the things that we need to be cognizant of. The fact is that making sure that we're not disrupting the wildlife and the marine wildlife that surrounds us.
Global warming is heating the Arctic four times faster than the rest of the planet, putting the local way of life in danger.
Oh, Starkers. He's such a cute boy. Oh, yeah. What a cute puppy.
My dogs are sled dogs. That's what their job is, and that's what's in their DNA. They're just waiting for winter like the rest of us.
Born into a family established here for the past three generations, David dreads the late return of the snow.
This is a culture that's dying, right? Dog sledding. We're worried about what's going to happen for my grandchildren and my great-grandchildren. I mean, this whole world is changing all the time, and unless people can get their stuff together, you know, and stop pollution and try to help our planet, Mother Earth will punish us for all the devastation that we're doing to her. You know, she's not going to sit still for it.
Global warming is moving fast. 40 years ago, during the Arctic summer, ice used to extend over 7 million square kilometers. Today, it's half that. Climate expert Flavio Lerner has little hope.
Generally, society is quite interested in reducing the risks. Throughout life, we all try to get insurance. We try to have a retirement fund if we can. So we are generally interested in reducing risks. It seems with climate change, we're lagging behind recognizing the risks that it poses for ecosystems and future generations. Well, as a scientist, I'm mostly interested in the processes. As a human and as sort of a citizen of Earth and being part of the problem, I'm worried.
In the calm of Hudson Bay, climate change is hard to ignore. For scientists, slowing its effects is paramount if the Arctic ecosystem is to be preserved, a critical element to the planet's survival.